Okay, so today I'm going to go over using OBS for my live studio drawing classes in Zoom. So I've been using OBS to have more control over my Zoom output, and this is how you do it. So first of all, you want to download OBS Studio. Here's the website. It stands for Open Broadcaster Software. Go ahead and download the OBS software, and then also download what's called the OBS Virtual Camera, and that will allow it to talk to Zoom. I'll post the links to both of these addresses in the description. So once you have OBS downloaded, you want to go ahead and open up the software, and it looks like this. And so I'm going to be creating a scene over here. This scene I'm called Drawing Demo. And I can, over here, I can add sources. And so I want to add as my first source a video capture device. So my video capture device could be my document camera. That's fine. Say OK. And I have a little document camera feed that looks great. All right, so I'm going to add this video source to my OBS. This is a live video feed. So I can go ahead and put this over here. Now, I tend not to need two video sources, although if you're doing sculpture, I could see you adding a second one. So here we go. Let's add an additional video capture device. Say we decide to use my camera webcam on my my laptop here. So I could see someone who is doing a sculptural demo needing two cameras. So you can control the size of these two cameras. And so say you're like the kind of person that really likes to, you know, do a side by side. You could have, you could have one pointed down at your drawing. And so people could see how you're doing something from more than one angle. That's not how I've been using it, but I just wanted to mention that that is an option here. So I'm going to go ahead and turn off my webcam. I don't need that for this demo. But what I do want is actually a photograph of the still life that I've been working on. So one of the problems that I've been having with my class is that they need to be able to see what I'm drawing and to see my drawing as I work on a demo together. So so here is the crop of a larger still life that I was using for this demo. So I kind of want this to be big. I can control the size of this. I can kind of manipulate it however you want. But this is great. So once you've got your scene set up and it's live and that looks the way you want it to be, OBS should save that arrangement in its program. So when you open it up again, it should be working. Now the next thing here, this is a little bit tricky. You want to make sure you click Start Virtual Camera. So I'm going to go ahead and click right here, Start Virtual Camera. And what that does is I have to actually make sure to remember to start that before I launch Zoom. Otherwise, it won't be able to find the virtual camera. So I'm going to go ahead and open up Zoom here. Please excuse this chaos. All right, so I've opened up Zoom. And I'm going to go ahead and just start a... going to start a little meeting here. So let's go ahead and invite you to my meeting. So a new meeting. We'll pretend this is my class, right? Welcome to class. And great. Now that I'm in Zoom here, I have a couple of options. And so what I can do is I can go over here to the video panel and click on it. And because I've installed OBS, I accidentally installed two OBS cameras, and you really should only do one. So I'm going to ask you how many cameras you want for your virtual camera. The answer is one. So I'm going to go ahead and click OBS camera one, which is the one that matters. And you can see now that my demo is this. And what's great about this is that this is live. I can manipulate this. I can work on this. They can see what I'm talking about and they can see my live drawing. I can zoom in on it. I can be like, all right, check it out. Good job over there. Check it out over here. Let's talk about whatever we need to talk about here in this demo. This is fine. So, and that is just something that has been really, really helpful to me. Now, I'm using it in a very simple way, but OBS is a powerful software that can be used in a number of different ways. The advantage here, though, is that in my Zoom recording of my class, it has a video feed of both the image that I want them to see as well as my demo in a single layout, and I control that layout. If I wanted to make a change here, I could go back to OBS and I could move this around, and you can see that in Zoom, it is responding immediately to that virtual camera. So if I decided I wanted to have, you know, my face, although with Zoom, I think the video camera is always kind of recording the teacher view as well, so I don't think it's actually necessary. I'm more concerned about getting my hands in the picture. But you could also include additional images. So you could have more than one diagram or what have you. You could have existing videos. Although I am concerned that the quality of running the video through Zoom would be kind of weak. So I would kind of hesitate to use that one. But there you go. That is using Zoom for using virtual cameras with OBS through Zoom. And I can switch back and forth to from OBS back to my webcam and teach. It's great. And then I can switch back to my OBS camera when I need to demo. So I feel like that's been facilitating my classes in a way that's been really helpful. So thank you so much. That's it.